This conference will now be recorded.
So more website traffic. So yeah, the audience. So getting more audience website. So what is the requirement to get more traffic on my website? So this will help me in search engine rankings. So how it is going to be helpful? So that we will talk in the next after this topic. So we are going to talk about the next thing is digital marketing process. Okay, so there I'll be explaining what is this traffic, how do we get more traffic towards our website, in what forms. The next thing is improve conversions. So how do we do that? We will discuss on that. The next is retention. Okay, so these are the objectives of the digital marketing. Fine. So now I request everyone to make a note on this. What are the process of digital marketing? So please type it as writing. So if you people are saying that you are writing, what are the things now I am going to explain to you people. So please type it as writing. Either you can use a notepad or you can use a WordPad on the system, or you can be able to write it in a book. Okay, so I'll put one by one process information on the chat box. So if you're not able to hear me in such instances, you can see the chat box and you can be able to find it what are the processes are there. Okay, so the first thing is so the first process is visibility. So what do you mean by visibility? So when you are saying that you are doing a business, so it has to be visible to the people, the general public. Okay, so if you are going to have a physical shop, then it will be visible physically. And the people who are going to pass by, they are going to see your shop and they will come to and do the businesses. Then after that, they are going to inform the people. So known people, you are going to get the crowd over there. Okay. So now on the digital platform, how you have to be visible? So being visible, digital platforms are in the form of, so by creating the websites. So you have to have, as a business person, you should have a visibility on the digital platform. The first and foremost thing is through the website or landing page. So is there any difference between the web page, website and landing page? Yes, website is a collection of multiple web pages and landing page is nothing but a single website page is called as a landing page. So that is the place where you are going to give all your business information in one single page. So that is called as a landing page. Okay, so you should be visible on the digital platform in the ways of by creating a website, by having a landing page, that is a single web page, or you should have a blog. Have you heard about this blog? Please type it as me, that if you have heard about blogs. Please Please type it as me, that if you have heard about blocks, that's very good. Fine. So you should be visible through the website, or it could be a landing page, or it could be a blog articles, or it could be through the social media pages. So when you are going to create the social media pages, so there will be two types of pages. One is going to be a personal profile, and another one is a business profile. Business page, we can call it. Okay, so having a personal profile, it will not helpful to your business. So you should also have an business profile account in each of the social media account. Okay, so the next thing is you should have a social media business profile pages. Then you should also register with the local listing people. So who are these local listing people? Means, so whenever there is a business in that particular area, so you should be able to get connected to those local listings, like Just Dial. Is there any other companies like Just Dial? Can anyone name it? Any other company similar to the Just Dial? Okay, so there are places like Yellow Pages also. Okay, so like this, there are people who are going to give you the services only to the local people. So suppose if you are searching for any person, electrician, a plumber, or a mechanic, so you are going to Just Dial, and you will dial the number, and you will be get connected to that executive. So when you are saying that you have a problem like this and you want the person to be attended with that, the first and foremost thing is they will ask you, you are from which area. So when you are specifically saying that you are from this particular area, so that particular area persons only will be assigned to you, so that you will get a quick responses from them. Okay, so like that, if you are going to register to this local listing people, so your business will be reached out, your business information will be reached out to your nearby people firstly. Okay, so these are the ways. I'll repeat it once again with the visibility process, that you are going to have an account in the Just Dial, Yellow Pages, or any other similar related to that. So then also you can be able to have a website, landing pages, or blogs, or social media business pages. So these are the ways you are going to be visible on the pages. The next one is the second process of digital marketing is bringing targeted traffic. So what do you mean by targeted traffic here? So targeted traffic means targeted customers or audiences, we can say. So how do we bring the targeted traffic towards us? So now we came to know that we should be visible on the digital platforms, that is through social media, or it could be search engine, that is on the websites or blogs, or it could be landing pages. So in all these spaces, if I'm going to register or record my details, then what is the use? So how do I can be able to reach out to the people? It is nothing but by using the search engine networks. Okay, so the search engine networks are nothing but the people who are going to give you the service of searches. So that is the company called Google, Bing, Yahoo, Ask.com, Amazon.com. These are the people who are providing this services. So Google is a product. So Google is a company which gives the services of search engine network. So why it is so much familiar? Good. So the first and foremost thing is, whenever we want anything to search it, either it could be a place or a food or anything. Okay. So yes, it's correct. It's user friendly. So people are nowadays they have become so much connected with that product, so that whatever they want, they are getting the information over there. How do they get the information? Because of we kind of people, our business people are going to put the information over there. Okay. So when we add any information, it can be reached out to the people. Okay. So the place where we are going to search for anything is called as a search engine. Okay. So this search engine network service providers are Google, Yahoo, Bing, Ask, then MSN. So like this companies, so we are using more the Google search engine for this reason. So it has become one of the topmost the competitor in the market in the search engine services. Okay, so how we are very used to it by calling as a Xerox. So Xerox is not actually the process name. It is, the process name is photocopy, but that process has been provided and made it easy to print out that photocopy is the Xerox is the company which has manufactured the machine. So, but we used a lot that Xerox copy. So now it has become as a part of it. Okay. So same way Google. Okay. So whatever we are going to type it on the search engine, that is called as a keyword. The word which we type it to search, so that word is called as a keyword, which is very important when you are writing a content. So you should be able to know the behavior of the audiences. So if it is any audience is going to search for anything related to your product or services, you should be able to assume it, that what are the words they are going to type it, what the common words they are going to use it. So you should be very much aware about your audience behaviors. Okay, so you can be able to identify that keywords and you can be able to record it while creating the content. Okay, so now when we are going to type that keyword, we will get the result. So that result page is called as search engine result page. The full the short name for us, it is SERP. The full form of SERP is search engine results page. So in the search engine results page, can I know that usually all the people are going to use it very oftenly, that is every day they are using with the Google. Okay, so when you are searching for anything, how many results you may get it on the search engine? Do anyone has an idea? Can type the number of pages? Even if it is wrong, it's okay. If you want to check and you can tell me the answer, no problem. Depends on the info and searches. Okay. So I can agree with this when you are saying it is how many pages are shown. Okay. So I know that it will not show only one page. Okay. I want to know that how many results are going to be shown in one page. 8 to 10. That's good. Okay. You will be able to see a 10 results in one page. Okay. So when you are going to see the 10 results, so in that 10 results, there will be two types of informations are provided. So first two or three results it is going to show, and that also it is depending upon the content, that is a keyword what you are searching for. So out of the 10 results, the first two or three what you are going to get the results. So you might have observed it, there will be word as ad. Have you observed it? If observed, type it as yes. Before starting the content, it will be showing the word as ad. Okay, so that kind of result we call it as. That is called as inorganic traffic. That means it is not coming naturally over there. It has been paid to that search engine company and they have made that result to be on the top of the result page. Okay. So inorganic traffic means the traffic which you are going to get it. So by paying the money to the search engine company, okay, so these are called as inorganic traffic. So the next type is organic traffic. So the other word of this is natural traffic. So that means you are going to get the audiences towards your business page organically or naturally. Okay. So why? What is the role of a digital marketer? Here it is. How to bring our business information on the top of the results page. Okay. So my next question, it will be for everyone. Please understand and try to answer for it. Tell me, if you are searching for anything, any result, for example, if I say you will be searching for a coffee shop. Okay. So except CCD, you will be searching for a coffee shop. So now let me ask you people that when you people are going to search for it, you will be seeing a 10 results. But whether all the people are going to see with view with all the 10 results. Is that everyone are going to see all the 10 results from the top to end of the page? No. Okay. So the next question is very good. So I got the answer before asking a question, Mithila, thank you. Okay, so is it only first three? Is there any person who can increase or decrease the number? Is it only the first three you people are going to consider it, or more than that? Is there anyone who is going to see more than 5, less than 10? So I take everyone are going to give the they accepted with only first three mainly. Okay, so now if you are going to select it only the first three, so you should also check it out whether all the three are with the advertisement or without advertisement. Okay, so as a user we will not be worried about it, so whether it is an advertised or it is going to be a natural way. Okay, but as a marketer over here, so I should be able to know that. So why the person has not clicked on that organic traffic result, instead of that why did they go for the paid one? Okay, so I should be able to analyze it and I should be able to change the content or in the way of representing our website or landing page or social media. So we should be able to make the necessary changes in that, so that I'll be able to be always the involvement of the digital marketer here. It is always keeping the information on the search engines on the topmost results in the first page. Okay, so it should be always on the topmost results. So some people, they may pay the money and they are going to put it. That is called as a inorganic traffic. Without paying the money, we can be able to keep it on the top of the result. Okay, so to learn by paying the money to the search engine company like Google, how we can be keep our advertisement on the top of the result page. So we will learn it through SEM. So getting the inorganic traffic through SEM process. Okay, or it is called as PPC ads. So can anyone try to tell me what is SEM and what is PPC? So you can try what is SEM and what is PPC. Good, PPC meant for pay per click. Good, that's very nice. It is search engine marketing and pay per click. Okay, so by paying the money to the search engines, how we can be able to get our advertisements on the top of the result page, that we will learn it through SEM. Then that is also called as inorganic traffic. So the other one is how to bring our business information on the top of the result page without paying in a single money to the Google search companies. Okay, so that is you can learn it through SEO concept. So SEO stands for Search Engine Optimization. Very good, Anusha. Thank you. Thank you, Anusha. Okay, so these are the two ways of where we can be able to get a audiences or traffic towards your digital platforms. Okay, so there is one more way, as earned traffic. So what is that earned traffic means? You are going to Sometimes you will pay the money to give your business information on such type of websites or any other forums. Okay, so some people, they will ask you to give your business information at free of cost also, or it will be on chargeable basis. How it can be a free of cost means it is mutual understanding between one user to another user. So one person is going to introduce another person's information on their website. Okay, so this is another name we what we call it as for this process, creation of backlinks. So it is one of the part of SEO strategy. So you have to create more backlinks. That is, you are promoting yourself on someone else's website. So that will help you to get more and more traffic to your website. Okay, so some people, they will charge you and they are going to run your information over there, or some people, they may not pay, ask you to pay, they will give it at free of cost. Is that clear to everyone with this? The first process was visibility, the second process was bring in targeted traffic. If you people have understood, please type it as move on. Okay, thank you for the responses. Now, the next question I may ask, do we need a break or shall we continue? Okay, so how many minutes break in the sense? Okay, so we shall take for 10 minutes of break, so and we will come back. Now it is exact 5, so we'll start the session at 5:10. Okay, so meanwhile, just have a look on all the contents what we have discussed, and if you have any kind of a doubt, you can raise it once we come back. Okay, thank you all. Be online. So welcome back after the break.
So is that everyone are physically, mentally are available in front of the session? Okay. So please type it as move on so that I can get a confirmation from you people that we can start the session. That's good. Thank you for all the responses. Good. So we have spoken about, we have discussed about two process. That is, first one is visibility, and the second one is on the bringing the targeted traffic. So the next process, it will be engagement. So what do you mean by engagement here in this process? So here the engagement is keeping engaged with the audience based on the content what you are going to create with it. And how do you link between one of your content in one page to another page? How you are going to backlinking it? So how you are going to optimize your URL link? So from one page to another page. So how you have designed your website? So this is how it is going to keep your audience, the visitor, in your digital platform for a longer duration. Okay, so by using the SEO concept, how we can be able to get it on the top of the result page means it is one of the thing which is going to make your website on always on the top of the result based on the average session it is going to be there. So average session, it should be always maintained as 10 minutes. So that means minimum 10 minutes if you are going to keep your audiences. So it will be always your SEO will be on the top. It will be optimized. And your website or the relevant business page, it will be there on the top of the result pages. Okay. So in this manner, so either you are going to keep it in one single page of your website or you are going to connect it to another page, but you are going to keep your visitor always engaged in the content on your platforms. Okay. So here, the average session should be 10 minutes and your bounce rate. So there is a terminology called bounce rate. There are certain terminologies. Please make a note of all those things. Okay. So session rates, bounce rates. So these are going to help you to know that how your web page or your business page it is performing. So in the tools, it is going to show it. Okay. So your bounce rate, it will be based on the page designing and the content what you have it. So here the bouncing means the person who is going to visit your web page or any of your business platforms on the digital platforms, so should not be going out of that particular page within a minute. So they are spending a time less than a minute. Okay, either it could be a 10 seconds, 20 seconds like that. So within a minute, if they are going to be out of your business pages, then your bounce rate will be increased. Hope you people were able to understand. Okay, so try to maintain with that the content. It is going to make them to feel it to be spend more time on your business pages. Okay, so the next thing is after engaging, it is conversions. So when you are going to say that it is a conversions, when do we say it as a conversion? Which when the person is going to show the interest, so they will come as a visitor to your business page, and once they are going to, yeah. Fine, I'll repeat it, Anisha. Between the bounce rate and the engagement. See, once you are going to go to that particular web page or the business page, once you are going to be entering into that page, if you are not spending more than a minute, so then it is increased with the bounce rate. So that means the person is not getting engaged for a longer duration on your business page. So that will be considered as a bounce. If the person is engaging, that is they are spending more time in your business page, so average session is going to be minimum 10 minutes. So then that person is engaged for a longer duration. Is that clear with this, Anisha? Good. Thank you for the response. Fine. So the next thing is conversions. So once the person is going to show the interest and is very much interested to take the services, so he is going to buy the product or take the services. But if you have a two choices, one, the product is same by the two different company. Okay, this is my questions to everyone. If there is two places where you have the same product which you like it to buy it, so one person says it is 100 rupees you have to buy it, and the other person says it's actually 100 rupees but we are going to give an offer of 10% discount. So which is the place you are going to select it to buy the product? The second place where the discount is available. Place with discount. Good. Thank you, Aisha and Vikasini. Is there anyone else? Who can give their suggestions? Good. So why do we go for a place with discount? So this kind of a, it is kind of, you are going to make the person, make the visitor to turn out into prospect and prospect into customer. So you are going to follow with certain kind of nurturing series. Okay, so I give the word as nurturing series. So it is one of the way to attract the people to get to take the decisions to buy the product at a faster. Okay, so whether we may give it with a discount or we may give it with some of a buy one get one free, or it may be some services we may give it at a free of cost which is worth more than the product. So there will be a maintenance charges for a year, it will be not being charged, that we call it as the annual maintenance charge, the AMCs, or it could be a subscription will be given for a free for certain days, or it could be in any format. So all this way of trying to make the people to get take the decisions on faster way, and they can be able to get converted, that's the process is called as a nurturing series. Okay, giving some freebies and you are going to capture your customers. Okay, so we are going to follow some of the nurturing series and then we are going to get our conversions of customers. So the next thing is measurement. So what are the measurements we are going to take it? So what are the measurements? So measurements means, what did we do to get this customers? Okay, so whether we are going to take any kind of services, after sale services, or we are going to forget our customers. Do we take any kind of after sale services? Is it that is a good process? Or is it you are going to forget that customer, we will try to hunt the another customer? Do you hunt your customer or do you farm your customer?
So you can type it as HUNT hunt or FARM farm. Do you want to hunt your customer or do you want to farm your customer? I'm expecting the responses. Okay, farm. Good. So when you are saying that you want to farm the customers, means you are going to make the people to feel it that they are in the right place. Okay. So here, if you are going to hunt means it is going to end of a business. Because if you are not going to say that what is your product, how you can be able to use it. So all this process, if you are going to give them, you if you are guiding them, you are going to give a demo on your products and services. So people will feel very comfortable on using your product. So most of the time when we buy it on the online product, why the still people are still buying the product on offline? Why can't they completely turn out into the online? So this is also one of the reason that if you buy it on the online, you will not be provided with the proper services, that you are not going to give a right guidance of using the product. So most of the people, they will not be knowing it. Why did they buy the product? Even they know it, why did they buy? They will not be knowing how to use the product. And there may be chances that they will not be having any ideas. They may not found out anywhere how to use the same product. Okay. But as a business person who is a seller of a product or services, should be taken care of those customers, how to use the product. Okay. So that is one of the measurements what we are supposed to take it. Okay. So this is one thing. The second thing is we should also take a measurement that why, how did we reach this customer? How we did convert our customers? Why did they buy the product from us? Okay. So this will help the people to know that how they are performing in their marketing wise, and if they found that the best way they can follow it, so that they can be able to gain more and more business out of it. So which is that the wrong process they followed with, and they were not able to be successfully get the sales, or what is that nurturing series they followed and they were able to get the customers on a faster way. So then you can be able to take the necessary measurements and you can be able to do the sales and marketing in faster way and get more and more sales and profit out of it. Okay. So this is related to measurement. The next and final process we can assume it as, it is retention. So retention means retain back. So whom to get back over here? So retain back is you are going to do the cross selling to the same customers. So for example, the person who has purchased product A from the company. So you are going to talk about product B and you are going to sell the product B to the same customer who has purchased my product A. Okay. So that is cross selling. So we are going to retain back our existing customer as a new customer for the new product. Okay. So this is one way. Then another way is doing remarketing or retargeting. We can use the word. Okay. So remarketing means the person who has shown the interest to us on our product or services, on our company products or services. So we are going to market them. We are going to forward the information of our products to the same people, but this time we may follow some of the new type of nurturing series, and we may try to attract them, and we can be able to convert them as a customers. So remarketing, it will be done to the prospects who has shown interest on the product, but they didn't buy it in the previously. So we will try to retarget them, and we will try to make them to convert from prospects into customers. Okay, so these are the six types of digital marketing process which we follow it. It could be on any type of business. So this is the process which we are supposed to follow with in the digital marketing. Is that clear with all? So type it as clear, if you are clear, and you can ask me the route if you have it. Thank you for the responses. Okay, so once after we came to know that what is the process of digital marketing, so now we will see that what are the types of digital marketing. Hope you people are able to see the screen. And here the first process what we are going to talk about is SEO. So SEO stands for search engine marketing, optimization. So these are the different types of digital marketing. So now if I go with this, SEO is the process of increasing the quality and quantity so quality so that is the content quantity it is how many people we are going to get it number of audiences in the organic way. Okay, so this is an example with the SEO optimized result in the organic way. So these are the companies. Okay, do you want to see the previous page? So we will come back once again to the same page in the coming slides. I'll show you it once again. That's fine. Okay, so these are the other companies. So these are the explanation on this. So this is the history of it. So Google was been founded in the year 1998. So it was serving 10,000 search queries per day. So by the end of 2006, so that was being served within a second. The whole day what it was working in 98, in 2006, it became for a second. Then in the September 1999, 1 year after being launched, Google was already answering 3.5 million search queries daily. So here you can be able to find it. So the difference between the organic marketing and the inorganic marketing. So if you want, you can take a screenshot of it. So organic results, the traffic, SEO, it will work for a very long time. For the longer duration, but it results will be immediately, it will take some time more. So comparatively inorganic way. Good. So the next thing is search engine marketing. So search engine marketing is the practice of marketing a business using the paid advertisements on search engines network. Okay. So and other websites, it says that is nothing but there are certain types of websites where they will allow the people to come and publish their information on the websites. Okay. So this is an example of display network marketing. So this is a website of some other company. So that is the Carvalho. So where it is allowing the person to run their ads of another company. Okay. So this is display network ads. And this is one of the way of having the ads. I think Ayushi, so you can see below this checkbox what you are seeing. Below that you can see some of the results. These are called as a SEO, that is organic traffic. Without paying the money, they are on the top of the result page. Ayushi, is it clear? Please type it as clear. If you're clear, okay, fine. So here you can be able to run the advertisement in a different format. One is in search network wise, that is only with the text wise we can be able to run it. Or these are called as the shopping ads, or the other word of this, product listing ads. Okay, so this is very important thing which you have to make a note on this. So these type of ads which is showing with the images, okay, so it is called as shopping ads. So the other word of it is product listing ads. So other one which we saw, it was a previous one, was display network ad. So that is running our advertisement on different website platforms. And this is video ads. So running the ads on the YouTube channel. So this is mobile app ads. Banner ads, then these are called as remarketing ads. There are multiple types of ad types. So when you are going to pay the money to that particular platform. So the next part is very important thing here. It is whenever you are creating the advertisement. So whether you are going to show the advertisement to all the people, or do you want to show the advertisement only to those people who are interested with such kind of products or services? So do you want to target your audiences specifically, or you want to target it on generally? Specific or general? Okay, so here it says targeting your audiences based on some criterias. Okay. So now, so when we are going to, yeah, thank you, Vanisha. So yes, it is based on the SCP, that is segmentation, targeting and positioning analysis. So Through this, we are going to target the people based on their locations. So if I am running my business in Bangalore, okay, so can I expect a person from the Delhi to come to my place and buy the product, even though the social media or digital platform is available anywhere in the globe? But I should be very much clear that the product which I am going to sell, it, whether it is going to be reached out to that person. If my product selling is only through the physical store, can I be able to send it? If I am not having the process of selling it like a e-commerce, is a e-commerce platform, so then I am not going to target the Delhi. I am going to target only that particular place which is nearby to my location. So I'll be targeting the people based on the location basis. The next, personal info wise. So most of the people will be observing that when you people are going to create any kind of social media accounts, so they will be asking you some of your personal information, interest, habits. So based on all this information, people will be targeted. So the next thing is professional info. In the same way how you are given with personal info at the time of creation of the accounts, the same way you will be given with some professional info also. So we are going to target the people if my product is related based on their professional information. The next is interest, that is what they are going to search on the internet, the activities on the internet. The next, behavior, so what they are going to share it on their social media accounts. So that behavior, based on that, it is going to show the advertisements. The next thing is retarget. So if they have not purchased the product, or if they have purchased the product, we will be keep on sending the information about our products or services. Okay, so this is the way how we are going to target our audiences. Okay, so here, if I am a user, if I am a buyer, so my information, it is already available to the seller, but this will be given by these companies to the seller. So they are making money. Why do the people are allowing you to create an account? At a free of cost, either while creating a social media like a Twitter account, or it could be Facebook account, or it could be Instagram account, at free of cost. They are not charging it because they are collecting your information and they are driving it to the marketers. So the marketers are going to spend the money on it and they are going to do the advertisement. Okay, and you are able to see the advertisements on your screens. Fine. So this is all about audience targeting and segmentations. So if you are going to create an advertisement on the search engine, so it looks like this, the text wise. So this is SEM, search engine marketing process, and this is SEO. So the next part is email marketing. So only creating the content and keeping it on our web page or social media page will not connect the people. Okay, it is not going to be there for long term. But if I want to make the people to get connected, so we are supposed to create some of the lead generation forms when they are going to visit our website or any of our business pages. So when you are going to create that lead forms, so in that, the mandatory information, what you will be asking it. So you people have been observed, or you might have been experienced, when you are going to search for any pages or any content, you will be reading it. And if you want to continue to read that, okay, any article. So when you click on continue, is it getting open with any kind of a form? like a submission form, subscription form? Are you people have been seeing such kind of things? It will be very important article. You will be very much involved in it. And when you click on continue, it will open with that form. Okay. So in that, what are the information they will be asking? Commonly, what are the information they may ask? And what are the information you will be ready to give with them? So the common information which it will be asked with, the name. So are you people are ready to give your name, contact number, mail ID and address? So out of this four information, which information you will be ready to give and which information you are not ready to give it? Please be genuine in this answer. What is that you are going to give it out of this four? So you can type it the numbers. If it is only one, type it as one. If you are giving it as two, mail ID, you are ready to give it. Good. Ready to give contact number and address will not be given. Yes. Okay. So this is the way of collecting your information. Okay. So by giving a mail ID, there is no problem to anyone. Okay. So they can't do anything with it. But for a marketer, this is more than enough. Why? Because if you are going to give a mail ID, it is understood that you are giving a permission to that person or to the company to send the mails. Okay. So this is one of the best way of marketing our businesses. Okay. So it is a permission based marketing. Okay. So when you are going to receive the mail of your users, so you will not keep it just like that as a collection of mail IDs. You will be starting to send a mail immediately. You might have been experienced that immediately when you are going to submit the form, you may get a mail. Thank you for choosing our the website, or it could be product, or it could be service. So in what ways they want to get identified? So they will say, thank you for reaching us. Okay. And after one day, they are going to talk about any particular topic related to their product in a general way. So the next day they will come up with they will say that their company history, they will say. On the next day they will talk about the product, and the next day they will talk about what are the usages, and the next day they will talk about what are the offers are available, and the next one or two days they will leave a gap and they will say a last day to buy this product, kindly buy it. So they will create that emergency with the person. So if person has been seen all these mails, he will take a decision on this. Okay. So this is one of the way of marketing, and it is personalizedly you can be able to get connected to these people. Okay. So you can be able to find more and more responses, the more prospects we can expect it through the email marketing, which is an effective way to capture high quality leads, that is prospects. Prospects is nothing but the person who is ready to buy it. Okay. And convert them to customers by sending the personalized emails to the targeted audience. So this is one of the example. So these are the process. It has been followed and it is successful as per the survey. Okay, if you want to take a screenshot of it, you can take it this. you can implement it in the future. Hope you people have taken the screenshot of it. Fine. So the next we will go with affiliate marketing. So what do you mean by affiliate marketing? Affiliate marketing is an effective way of digital marketing that involves a merchant paying commissions to one or more affiliates. So what do you mean by affiliate? It is a connection between the buyer and the seller. So here, when you say that you are going to do the digital marketing, so here the question arises, whether do you want to promote your own product and make a sales and make a money out of it, or there is another chance, that another way of earning money, that is by promoting someone else's product on your platform and you are going to make a money out of it. So when you're promoting others' product on your platform, then it is called as a affiliate marketing. Okay, so hope you people understood with this. So this is an explanation. What is affiliate marketing? So if you want, you can take a screenshot of it. Okay, so the affiliate marketing can be done in all these ways. So that is creating a reward sites or content sites and blogs, or through the emails also you can do it, or you can be able to run the ads, PPC affiliate, then comparison websites, you can bring it, then retargeting affiliates, then vouchers and deal site, and social affiliates. These are the types of affiliate platforms. So these are all the examples. You can observe over here the affiliate link, which is very familiar places like Flipkart, Amazon. So it has not been shown this information on the Flipkart or Amazon. So these details are provided in a website called Digit. Okay, so in this digit, they will be talking about what are the electronic goods are available in the market and its features. All those things, we are going to explain it. And finally, you will not be selling that product because you are not the owner of the product. You don't own any kind of product. What you are doing, you are working, you are going to sell it on behalf of Flipkart. So you are going to have a link with the Flipkart people. So they will create an affiliate link and they will provide it to you, that you can be able to add it over here at the behind the website creation screens. So which we will be seeing in our coming classes. Okay, how we can add a link over there to click on it. So it is called as a call to action button. So the term which is used over there, the button which you are going to use it to buy the product, it is called as call to action button. Okay, so this is one way of doing the affiliate marketing. So these are the peoples who are earning the money by talking about that product, and they are going to give a link of those buying products. So this is also one of the way of doing the affiliate marketing on the YouTube. So these are the some of the examples of how they are going to earn the money, that is through the affiliate marketing. So this person earns $60,000 per month. So I think most of them are well aware about this person on the YouTube, the person who comes with more cooking related recipes. And this person, she is very much older that and she has been passed away very long back. So this is the kid which is earning the money by showing how to use the toys. And this person who is paid for seeing how she will eat and she will enjoy it and she will talk about that product. Okay, so these are the examples what we are going to see it on the affiliate marketing. So the next thing is social media marketing. As you all know that social media websites, which are the social media platforms, are there. So creating the page over there, till now what you people were creating the accounts, they are all called as a personal profiles. But now in the coming classes, we will see that the same places, how we can be able to create the business pages and we can be able to promote those pages. Okay. The next is content marketing. So these are all the examples. Then it comes with content marketing. It is an effective marketing technique of creating and distributing valuable online content. Okay, so this going to play a major role. Either it could be on a free medium or it could be paid medium. So how you will be able to get more and more audiences towards your digital platforms? So it will be through the content what you are going to create with. Okay, so once you are going to create with the content, so in the different platforms, especially with the website or landing page or with the blogs, you can be able to connect that into a tool called Google Analytics, which will measure the website traffic and its behaviors. Either it could be on the website or it could be on the app to make meaningful decisions for the websites. So these are all the graphical representations, how it looks like. So this is the sales triggers. So how you can be able to make a sales in a faster way. Okay, so you should be talking about the benefit, you should be talking about the fear of not having that product at the time of fear. If this product was there, so how it would have been helped? So they should feel that regret that why didn't we add this product. And you should also talk about the offer. So when you talk about all the positivities, you are also saying that you are providing it at a very nominal charges so that they can buy it immediately. They can take decisions as faster than normal way. So these are the some of the examples of email contents, how they create the importance of that particular product, creating the fear, or it could be regressions. So creating the emergency or urgency. So there are two ways. One is saying the scarcity. So that means they may miss this opportunity. So these are some of the examples, the words we use it for creating the scarcity. So this is another one, a clock timer or countdown. So it says that we are going to end up with. So this is also one of the example of the email. When you are going to miss your audiences, they are not purchased the product, they didn't get converted. So how you can be able to remarket to them through the email? So this is going to be one of the example for it. Okay, so this is how you are going to target your customers. So first you have to bring with the awareness, then make them to consider, explore your products, and then make the platform to make a purchases in a proper way, in a comfortable way, and make them sure that they are going to buy it by knowing the product, how to use it. So this will target them to make a purchase of it. Okay, so by this we can end up with this session. We came to know what is digital marketing, what are the process involved in digital marketing, then what are the types of digital marketing we have come across with. Okay, is there any doubt on the details what we have been discussed till now? Any topic, only what we have been discussed with, any kind of doubt not understood with? You can raise your questions. Okay, so can I get a confirmation with you people, where you people were comfortably can understand the way of me going with the session? Is it okay? Is it fast? Not able to understand? Okay. Thank you for your responses. Okay, fine then. So we'll meet tomorrow at same time, 4 o'clock. We will come with a new concept, which is called as a Google My Business. Okay. So meantime, I want you people to be prepared with. Okay. So please make a note of this, which I'm going to type it on the chat box. So I want you people to come up with tomorrow by with your business names. So for example, now if I want to do the marketing, digital marketing means I should be able to have a business to promote it. Okay, either on the organic way or inorganic way, without paying money or with paying money. So in this scenario, I should be able to say that what is my business is. Okay, so I want you people to come up with your business name. Then I want to know about your business description. How do you describe your business? So keep it ready, everything content on any word pad, so that you can be able to copy paste it whenever it is required, because based on this only we are going to continue with the coming sessions. Okay, so every time you can't be keep on thinking on same thing. Okay, so business name, business description, business category it relates to, and business location. So in which part of the globe do you want to run this business location? If it is online business, you can take it as online, but be very much practical on these things. Okay, so if you are owning a business and you want to promote it, means how it should be. So the in that way you should be able to think on that and keep it ready with all those things. Okay, so business name, business description, business category, and business location. Okay, and with this, I also request you people to be ready with 5 images on your business related. Either you create a images or you will download it at free of cost from the Google or any websites. That's okay. So minimum 5 images you should keep it, and 1 logo. Logo is an identification of your business. Okay, so it can be created. I can refer you with a website called canva.com. Go to the canva.com website and try to create it. Okay, if not able to create it, then we can see it in the tomorrow's class how we can be able to create with a logo on the canva.com website. Okay, so be ready with this. Thank you all. Have a nice day.